Hello guys, so in this video I'm going to show you how we can create our own Happy New Year countdown app using MIT App Inventor. So what I've done, let me just change that horizontal to background color to something. Okay, so you will see like this. Okay, so that's our countdown app. Okay, that's the design. So what I've done here, it's really very simple app. Okay, so we are not using here any extension. Okay, you can create your own on countdown app without using any extension. So what I've done here, as you can see, this is the background of our screen. Okay, click on the screen. As you can see here, I've just added one picture in the background image like this. Done. And I've added one here, horizontal arrangement, one layout. Okay, like this. And I've added multiple levels, like 8 level I have used, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I've just defined the, font size should be like, if this size is like 15 and 46, 44 and like 38, like this. Then now this is the design. Nothing is here. Now what we need to do, we just need to add 3 components here. Is first one is our date picker, this one date picker. So we can get the day. We need here one timer, time picker. As you can see here, there is one time picker. See this one. We need to just get the time picker also. Okay. So we have the 2 components. Now we need a clock also. So we can use here, countdown. So as you can see here, there's sensor option. In the sensor, you will see the clock. Just drag and drop it here. Simple. Now let's go to the block. Now, as you can see, this is the code. Okay. This is really very simple code. Let me just explain you. It's very basic. So whenever someone open an app, it means the screen will initialize. Okay, so click on the screen and you will see the screen initialization component. This one, so once the screen will initialize, we need to set label 1 dot text value. See, this is the label 1. Okay, this is the label 1. We need to set that value to the 31 minus the date picker dot day. Means suppose this today is suppose the 9th of December or 11th of December or 15th of December. So 31 minus 15, okay, or 31 minus 10. If suppose today is the 10th December, then 31 minus 10, it will become the 20. What will it? It will become 19. Okay, so this will automatically set the remaining days using in the label. You got my point? How this will work? We are just fetching the current day. Okay, current day. If suppose this today is suppose the 31st. So this value defined as a 0. Okay, you got my point? Now, as you can see here, time picker is dot R. So what have you done? 24 minus, suppose today is the 12, right now it's 12 p.m. So, and 31st, but it's, 12 a.m. suppose, and it's 31st. So we still have the 12 R. So 24 minus 12, it means equal to 12. Okay, so this will define the 12 value here. And this is for the minute. So whatever the time minute is, so this will just minus the by 60 and this will set the time. And label 4 is for seconds. I have just defined the 60 seconds. Now we have used our timer. As you can see here, you can use the timer like this clock, and you just need to define the time interval should be 1000. This will define as a 1 second. Okay, 1000 is equal to 1 second. Go to the block. Now, as you can see, set label dot text to label 1 text minus 1. So whenever timer will fire, so we need to minus the second value in every second. Okay, suppose it's 60, then it's going to be 59, 58, 57, like this. And we just need to check the condition every time. If the label 8 dot text value, so what is label 8? So as you can see here, label 8 is this seconds. Like this, if label 1 dot value is 0, then we'll automatically again set this value to 60. See, level 8 is 60. But we need to set level 3. What is level 3? Level 3 is our minute. This is a minute. Okay, so this is the minute. So level 3 value should be minus by level 3. Suppose the timer is, the minute is 22. So that will minus to 21. Okay, same condition we have again used, level 3 is equal to 0. When the level 3 becomes a 0, then will what will then just let me just hide it because I just use enable block. Level 3 again to the 60, but level 2 value should be minus by 1. And what is the level 2? Level 2 is a R. Okay. And label, this is the level 1, and this level 1 is a day. Okay. So once the people, once the value of level 2 will become the 0, so we need to minus the level 1 value. But when, if the value is level, if the value is level 1, is going to be a 0, then we just level 1. If the level 1 value is 0, okay, then we need to just false the horizontal arrangement, and we need to make this level 6 should be true. It means the happy new year. Suppose if today is the 31st, and this condition will be a true because it's a 0, right? So this will automatically hide, and but still we have the 10 R remaining. How this will work? Okay, so it's simple. What I will do here, I'll use here the condition under that F, then under this F, and under this F. Why? If it's true, then this will done. If it's not true, then nothing will happen. If it's true, then this will work. If it's true, then this will work. You got my point? Okay. So in this app, as you can see here, that's the value. Okay. And I'm just using here very fast timer. It's milliseconds. Okay. So you can use your seconds. Okay. You can just set the timer in the seconds. Like once this second is completed, then minute, then hour, then days. So as you can see here, there's 22 days remaining for the new year. Okay. So whenever you open your app, this will look like this. What I have done, I have just set 4 value to the year, like the days, like, okay. So what will happen? See, after completing the 22 days, this will look like this. That timer will hide and automatically happy new year 2024. It will look like that. Okay.
So that's the overall app. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment. Please subscribe to my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.